Welcome to the continuation of our series of seminars at Regis. Today I would like to talk to you about structural elucidation of impurities by two-dimensional NMR. There is no debate that structural elucidation is very important, and we have federal regulations and ICH guidelines who clearly state that if impurities exceeding certain thresholds, they should be identified. We found that NMR is actually a major tool for structural elucidation. NMR spectroscopy evolved over many years from a completely theoretical concept to a very useful practical tool. And it's one of the greatest fundamental discoveries of the 20th century. You can see there were like three Nobel Prizes awarded in physics, two in chemistry, and even in biology and medicine, and all because of the versatility of NMR as a tool to look at the intimate structure of the matter. And like a microscope for biologists, microbiologists, NMR became a most important tool for chemists, which allows us to understand the interactions between atoms and the molecules, and finally elucidate the structure. Today NMR is known for more than 50 years now, and still it's not widely used by chemists. In many cases, while doing structural elucidations, chemists prefer to use one-dimensional NMR. And there are also another extreme, because of the so many new methods of NMR appeared. There are multiple of two-dimensional NMR methods. There is a danger to use lots of expensive methodology for the resolution of simple structures. So in order to avoid this, we developed at Regis a workflow which allows us to elucidate structure in very economical way, save time and money, at the same time provide this service to our customers as pharma services. And here I would like to talk to you about our workflow. So obviously, initial step for any structural elucidation, we need to have this impurity in hand. So we have to isolate this impurity. And it's a good idea to determine molecular formula by using mass spectroscopy data. And then it's an NMR turn. We have to acquire 1D NMR data. I would say for experienced chemists, it's not a necessity anymore. But because it doesn't take too much of equipment time, it's still a good idea to have both proton and carbon NMR and also do deuterium exchange to find out what atoms are exchanged in the structure. And then we can start with acquiring 2D NMR spectra. Again, I would say because there are so many methods and two-dimensional methods of NMR, we try to limit activities using those three methods: HSQC, COSY, and HMBC. HSQC data together with H1 and carbon-13 data will help us to label the protons and then find the carbons directly attached to the protons. We also are able to identify exchangeable protons either from H1 experiment with deuterium exchange or directly from HSQC data. We also can easily identify quaternary proton carbons. And at the end of this, check number of protons and carbons and verify that they support molecular formula, because we have molecular formula already from mass spectroscopy. And then we go and analyze COSY spectrum, which allows us to correlate protons separated by several bonds. These correlations are extremely important because they allow us to build a fragment structures and basically have bits and pieces of the molecular structure of our compound. And finally, when we analyze HMBC spectra, we can correlate protons and remote carbons, and we'll be able to connect those spin systems, having more or less complete picture of the molecular structure of the molecule. It's not the end, though. We need to think about chemical origin of the impurity, and if necessary, acquire additional spectral data, which are quite inexpensive, typically FTIR and UV if necessary. I would say that knowing how this impurity was made and what process it came from, it's important because logic in all this, it's still number one tool, although we have number of NMR technique and other different methods. But the logic is still important because we need to realize that the information we have should be used efficiently.